Hello dear students, so last class we learnt about linear magnification and value of a linear magnification at a different instance depending upon position of the object. And we know that linear magnification, so it is the ratio of height of the image to the height of the object, or this is equal to minus v divided by u in terms of object distance and image distance. Even though we can express this linear magnification in terms of focal length, object distance, and focal length and image distance. So we know that mirror equation, that is 1 by f is equal to 1 by f is equal to 1 by v plus 1 divided by u, the mathematical relation between focal length, object distance, and image distance. Now I am going to multiply this equation by v on both sides. Multiplying v on both sides, v by f is equal to v by v 1 plus v divided by u. So we know that linear magnification in terms of object distance and image distance, that is v divided by u. Therefore, I am going to separate this term. V divided by u is equal to v by f minus 1, v by f minus 1. Then v divided by u is equal to LCM f v minus f. Now I am going to multiply by negative sign on both sides. Minus v divided by u, because minus v by u is nothing but linear magnification, is equal to f minus v divided by f. This is nothing but magnification. Now this linear magnification is in terms of focal length and image distance. If given data is in terms of focal length and image distance, then we can use this formula to calculate a linear magnification. And similarly, 1 by f, by multiplying this equation by u on both sides, then u by f is equal to u by v plus u by u 1. So that linear magnification contains u and v. Therefore, I am going to separate this term. U divided by v is equal to u by f minus 1. U by v is equal to f u minus f. Then taking the reciprocal of this term, because m is v by u, not u by v. V by u is equal to f divided by u minus f. And again multiplying by negative sign on both sides, minus v divided by u is equal to f divided by f minus u. So this is another formula. So here linear magnification, that this minus v by u, minus v by u is equal to f minus v by f in terms of focal length, image distance. Here in terms of focal length and object distance. Therefore, linear magnification, another formula, is equal to focal length minus image distance divided by focal length. So this is in terms of height of the image and height of the object, or in terms of image distance and object distance. Then this formula is in terms of focal length and image distance. Another one, linear magnification is equal to focal length divided by focal length minus object distance. Okay, so depending upon the given data, we can use any one of this formulae to calculate linear magnification. See here. So this formula applicable both in case of a concave spherical mirror and convex spherical mirror. And while solving the numericals, again we should apply the Cartesian sign convention. So next one, refraction of light. So refraction of light is nothing but change in the path of light. When a light tends to travel from one medium to another medium of different optical density. Otherwise, if there is no change in medium, then there is no change in path of light. Only when light made to travel from one medium to another medium of different optical density, so this is known as a refraction of light. So in air or vacuum, we know that velocity of light is 3×10⁸ meter per second. Except air or vacuum, in any other optical media, velocity of light is less than 3×10⁸ meter per second. So let us note on the definition of refraction of light. Refraction of light the phenomenon of change in path of light when a light travels, when it travels obliquely from one medium to another medium of different optical density. Different optical density. So this is known as a refraction of light. So let us consider two optical media. So here optical medium is nothing but the medium which allows light to pass through it. So that medium is known as optical medium. Media means plural, medium singular. So let us consider optical pair of optical media. So this is the interface between two optical media. So let us say this medium is rarer medium, this medium is denser medium. Rarer, denser, thinner, thicker. The interface between rarer and denser medium. Let us consider an incident light ray. Incident light ray. Straight line represents path of light and arrow mark represents direction of light. Normal at the point of incidence. Normal at the point of incidence. Rarer to denser. Rarer. Denser. If suppose this medium is air or vacuum. In air or vacuum, velocity of light is 3×10⁸ meter per second. When it travels from air to other optical medium, let us say water, glass, diamond, kerosene, except air or vacuum, then there is a decrease in velocity of this light. When there is a decrease in velocity of light, then here it bends towards this segment. See here, we are going to plot this segment at the point of incidence. That means in order to represent point of incidence. And this dotted segment is perpendicular to the interface. Interface is nothing but separation between two media, rarer, and this side is denser. This dotted segment is perpendicular to the interface. And hence this dotted segment is known as normal, because angle between these two segments is equal to 90 degrees. When the light travels from a rarer medium to denser medium, it bends towards the normal. It bends towards the normal. Straight line represents path of light and arrow mark represents direction of light. This light ray is known as incident light ray, and this light ray is known as refracted, not reflected. This is not a mirror. This is the interface between one medium to another medium. Incident light ray, a refracted light ray. See here. Here there is a change in the path of light. If you are going to analyze speed of light or velocity of light in this denser medium, then that value is less than 3×10⁸ meter per second. Due to decrease in speed in a denser medium, this refracted light ray bends towards the normal. See here, if this refracted light ray bends towards the normal, that represents there is a decrease in speed of light in that given optical medium. So in this ray diagram, angle between incident light ray and a normal at the point of incidence, this angle is known as angle of incidence and it is represented by I. Angle between a refracted light ray and a normal at the point of incidence, this angle is known as angle of refraction and it is represented by small r, because capital R is radius of a curvature. Here small r represents angle of refraction. Rarer to denser, it bends towards the normal because decrease in speed of light. Similarly, so let us consider the combination of denser and rarer. Incident light ray, path of incident light ray, direction of incident light ray, normal at the point of incidence. Normal at the point of incidence. If suppose this first medium is a denser medium, denser medium, and second medium is a rarer medium, when light tends to travel from denser to rarer, then it bends away from the normal. It bends away from the normal direction of refracted light ray. So away from the normal because increase in the speed of light. If suppose here speed of light is less than 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, if this second medium is air or vacuum, then here velocity of light is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. That means there is an increase in speed of light. Due to increase in speed of light, it bends away due to increase in speed. Increase in speed away from the normal. Decrease in speed towards the normal. Again, angle between incident light ray and normal at the point of incidence, this angle is known as angle of incidence. Angle between a normal and a refracted light ray, this angle is known as angle of refraction, R. Rarer to denser, denser to rarer medium. So this is known as incident light ray. Incident ray. This one is a refracted light ray. A refracted ray. Again here incident ray, refracted ray. So let us consider the actual path of incident light ray. If there is no any change in medium, if there is no change in medium means there is no change in optical density, same medium, then there is no change in path of light. Then light travels along this straight line without any deviation. Actual path of incident light ray. This dotted segment represents actual path of incident light ray in the absence of this second medium, or if there is no any change in optical density. Similarly, actual path of incident light ray in the absence of this optical medium. Again, this dotted segment represents actual path of incident light ray in the absence of second medium. The angle between a refracted light ray and a incident light ray, or actual path of incident light ray, this angle is known as angle of deviation. It is represented by small d, angle between refracted light ray and incident light ray, or incident light ray extended. That means this is the path of incident light ray. So that angle is known as angle of deviation. So this angle is angle of refraction, that is small r, between a refracted light ray and a normal at the point of incidence. This total angle, that is angle between normal and actual path of incident light ray, this total angle is equal to r plus d. This total angle is equal to r plus d. Similarly, in this ray diagram, the angle between a refracted light ray and path of incident light ray, this angle is known as angle of deviation, and it is represented by small d. This total angle is r and this angle is d, then this angle is equal to angle between normal and actual path of incident light ray is equal to r minus d. So already these terms are familiar for us. We learnt these terms in a reflection of light, angle of incidence, angle of reflection, angle of deviation. Similarly, here angle of incidence is nothing but angle between incident light ray and normal at the point of incidence. Angle of refraction is nothing but angle between refracted light ray and normal. Angle of deviation is nothing but angle between refracted light ray and actual path of incident light ray. That angle is known as angle of deviation. See, in these two cases there is a change in path of light, because there is a change in optical density. Optical density of rarer medium is different, optical density of denser medium is different. That is depending upon arrangement of the molecules. In other words, we can say here in rarer medium molecules are loosely bound, here molecules are tightly bound, rarer to denser. For that reason, there is a decrease in speed of light. Now from this ray diagram, you just observe this ray diagram, angle of incidence is equal to r plus d, because these two angles, these two angles are vertically opposite angles. Here angle of incidence and here r plus d. Therefore, from this ray diagram, I is equal to r plus d, and light travels from rarer to denser. Then expression for deviation, angle of deviation is equal to I minus R. So this is the case when the light travels from rarer to denser. I minus R. That means when the light travels from rarer to denser, angle of incidence is greater than angle of refraction, because refracted light ray bends towards the normal And hence here we are going to consider this r in terms of negative sign. Similarly, from this ray diagram, angle I and r minus d, vertically opposite angles. From this ray diagram, I is equal to r minus d, then d is equal to r minus I. When a light tends to travel from denser to rarer, it bends away from the normal. That means angle of refraction is greater than angle of incidence. Therefore, I is in terms of negative sign in case of rare, denser to rarer. So this is the expression for deviation in case of denser to rarer, and light travels from denser medium to rarer medium. Here, while writing the definition of this refraction of light, we are going to use the term when a light travels from one medium to another medium of different optical density, or light undergoes oblique incidence. When light we are going to consider rarer to denser or denser to rarer, we are going to write the definition, the phenomenon of a change in path of light. When a light tends to travel obliquely from one medium to another medium, why should we prefer oblique incidence? So that is the point here. Here, if you are going to consider normal incidence in the sense along this normal, in this case, there is no change in path of light. Both incident light ray and a refracted light ray tends to travel in the same line, and hence it is quite difficult to analyze change in path of light. Obviously, there is a decrease in velocity of light. Even though when we are going to consider normal incidence, it is quite difficult to analyze because both the path of incident light ray and refracted light ray tends to travel along the same line. For that reason, we are going to consider oblique incidence. So it is easy to understand the change in path of light due to change in velocity. So light travels with a different speed in a different optical media. So that is the cause for this refraction of light. Due to that reason, there is a change in path of light when light travels from one medium to another medium of different optical density. Next one, laws of refraction. So it is also known as Snell's laws of refraction. So Snell is nothing but a name of the scientist. Laws of refraction are Snell's laws of refraction. So let us consider a ray diagram. Light tends to travel from rarer to denser medium. Incident light ray, normal at the point of incidence, rarer to denser, it bends towards the normal. Direction of refracted light ray, rarer, denser. Angle of incidence, angle of refraction. So this is the interface between a rarer and a denser medium. Now, as like as a laws of reflection, in case of laws of refraction, you just observe this ray diagram. Incident light ray, refracted light ray, and a normal at the point of incidence all lie on the same plane. If you are going to plot this ray diagram on the board, then incident light ray, refracted light ray, and a normal lie on the plane of the board. If you are going to plot the ray diagram on the paper sheet, then these three lie on the plane of the paper. Note down, first one, incident ray, incident light ray, refracted light ray, light ray, and a normal at the point of incidence all lie on the same plane. Same plane. Second one, the ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction is equal to constant. If you are going to consider the ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction, you will get some constant value, some numerical value. That constant value remains same in case of given pair of media and light of given wavelength. And that constant value represents optical density. That constant value represents optical density. That optical density is known as refractive index of the medium. Another name of optical density is a refractive index. The ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction is equal to constant for a given pair of media and for light of given wavelength. This constant value is known as refractive index. This refractive index is just a number. It measures optical density of the medium. It is as like as a rule number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 is greater than 4. 4 is greater than 3. 3 is greater than 2. 2 is greater than 1. If you want to consider the combination of 1 and 2, 2 denser, 1 rarer. If you're going to consider the combination of 4 and 5, 5 is denser, 4 is rarer. Like this, this constant value represents optical density of the medium. That optical density is nothing but a refractive index of the medium. Second one, the ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction the ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction is constant for given pair of optical media and light of given wavelength. So mathematically we can write sine I divided by sine R is equal to constant. This constant is known as refractive index. Or we can write RI. RI is nothing but refractive index. Or if you want, you can write one more sentence. And the light of given wavelength, this constant is known as a refractive index. Of the medium. So we can write refractive index as RI. So here R capital R, capital I represents refractive index. Then mathematically we can write sine I
divided by sin r is equal to constant. So this constant is known as a refractive index,
and a refractive index, it is represented by n
sin I r. Sin I divided by sin r is equal to n.
Sir, in your annual examination, they may ask for 2 mark. State Snell's laws of refraction. Then you should write these 2 laws. Or state laws of refraction. And here, in case of refractive index, I already told you people, refractive index, it measures optical density. It is a just number. That means there is no any unit and dimensional formula for this refractive index. So we can categorize this refractive index into 2 cases, relative refractive index and absolute refractive index. Now what is the meaning of this relative refractive index? Or you can write types of refractive index. Refractive index in bracket n. First one, a relative refractive index. A relative refractive index. So relative refractive index is nothing but a refractive index of the medium with respect to another medium other than air or vacuum. So that is known as relative refractive index. So let us consider the ray diagram. Incident light ray, normal at the point of incidence, a refracted light ray, angle of incidence, angle of refraction. According to Snell's laws of refraction, sin I divided by sin r is equal to constant. That constant is known as refractive index of the medium. So refractive index of the medium means here we are going to consider 2 optical media. That means this value belongs to which medium, whether first medium or second medium. sin I by sin R is equal to constant. That constant is known as a refractive index. That refractive index is nothing but a constant value that belongs to the optical medium at which we can observe change in path of light. That means this ratio gives refractive index of this second medium. This is the first medium, this one is second medium. If suppose there is no change in optical medium, then there is no change in path of light. Due to this optical medium, there is a change in path of light. It bends towards the normal. So change in path of light occurs in second medium. Therefore, this ratio gives refractive index of second medium, not first medium. This ratio gives the value of optical density of a second medium, not first medium. That optical density is nothing but refractive index. So here, relative refractive index is nothing but a refractive index of the medium other than air or vacuum. For example, I am going to consider water and glass. Combination of water and glass other than air or vacuum. During this instant, if you are going to calculate the refractive index of the medium at which we can observe change in path of light, that refractive index of the medium is known as a relative refractive index. Refractive index of the medium Ri of the medium with respect to another medium other than air or vacuum. So that is known as a relative refractive index. Okay. So in this case, there is a change in path of light in second medium. Then I am going to write relative refractive index. N represents refractive index. Change in path of light occurs in second medium. 2 with respect to first medium. 1. N subscript 2, 1 represents, this first digit represents change in path of light occurs in second medium, not in first medium. So here, relative refractive index is equal to, again applying Snell's law, sin I divided by sin R. That means this medium is, let us say, water, and this one is glass, combination of water and glass. Refractive index of glass with respect to water is nothing but a relative refractive index. So it is represented by N21. This first digit represents, in that medium we can observe change in path of light. So again, by applying Snell's law, we will get a constant value. That constant value is known as relative refractive index of glass. That is a refractive index of glass with respect to water. And also, this is equal to the ratio of velocity of light in first medium to velocity of light in second medium. Let us say velocity of light in first medium is V1, velocity of light in second medium is V2. And also that is equal to the ratio of wavelength of light in first medium to wavelength of light in second medium. Let us say lambda 1 be the wavelength of light in first medium and lambda 2 be the wavelength of light in second medium. Instead of a sin I divided by sin r, even though by considering the ratio of velocity of light in first medium to velocity of light in second medium, we will get same value. Same constant value. That constant value is nothing but a relative refractive index. So this is equal to velocity of light in first medium to velocity of light in second medium, or this is equal to wavelength of light in first medium to wavelength of light in second medium. So this is nothing but a relative refractive index. Next, absolute refractive index. Absolute refractive index. A refractive index of the medium with respect to air or vacuum. So that is known as absolute refractive index.
RI of the medium with respect to air or vacuum.
It is known as absolute refractive index. So air or vacuum means here first medium. Incident light ray, normal refracted light. This first medium is air or vacuum. So this second one is any other optical medium like water, glass, anything. So here change in path of light occurs in second medium. This one first medium, second medium. If you are going to apply Snell's law at the point of incidence, see here we can apply Snell's law at the point of incidence. If you are going to apply Snell's law at the point of incidence, again that ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction gives constant value. That constant value is known as refractive index of second medium, because in this case change in path of light occurs in second medium, not in first medium. Therefore, that ratio gives a refractive index of second medium with respect to air or vacuum. Therefore, that refractive index is known as absolute refractive index. So, N is equal to sin I divided by sin r. This is equal to, again we can express this absolute refractive index in terms of velocity. So velocity or speed of light in air or vacuum is 3 into 10 to the power 8. It is represented by c, and here velocity of a light in the medium is v, air or vacuum. So this is equal to velocity of light in air, c, divided by in velocity of light in given optical medium. And this is equal to wavelength of light in vacuum or air to wavelength of light in given optical medium. Wavelength of vacuum wavelength of light in given optical medium. So this is known as absolute refractive index. Even though we can write this absolute refractive index as relative refractive index n to 1, but we should understand the first medium is air or vacuum in case of absolute refractive index. So here n is nothing but absolute refractive index. So even though we can write that n as n to 1, but that first medium is air or vacuum in case of absolute refractive index. A relation between relative refractive index and absolute refractive index.
Relative RI and absolute RI. So let us consider the medium. So first medium is air or vacuum. Light ray tends to travel from air to other optical medium. Direction of incident light ray, normal at the point of incidence. It bends towards the normal. Air or vacuum. So here velocity of light is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second and it is represented by c. In this medium, velocity of light, let us say v1 be the velocity of light. I am going to name this medium as medium 1. So this is understood, that is air medium. So in this medium, velocity of light is v1. Then applying Snell's law, at the point of incidence, I and R, n is equal to sin I divided by sin R. This is equal to velocity of light in air to the velocity of light in given optical medium, that is c divided by v1. So this is our assumption. In this medium, velocity of light is v1. Let us say velocity of light is v1. That means this ratio gives a refractive index of this medium. And the name of this medium is medium number 1, that is N1 with respect to air or vacuum. If there is no any digit after this first digit, that is understood absolute refractive index. And second case, another combination. Incident light ray
normal at the point of incidence. Again, air to other optical medium, it bends towards the normal. Angle of incidence, angle of refraction. And the name of this medium is medium number 2. Let us say velocity of light in this medium is V2. Again, in air or vacuum, velocity of light is C, 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. Applying a Snell's law at the point of incidence. So here, change in path of light occurs in second medium with respect to air or vacuum, that is absolute refractive index, absolute. This is equal to sin I divided by sin R is equal to C divided by V2, the ratio of velocity of first medium to the velocity of second medium. Again, that ratio gives constant value. That constant value is known as refractive index of second medium or refractive index of the medium at which we can observe change in path of light. Change in path of light. So let us say equation number 1, equation number 2. Then combination of medium 1 and medium 2. Medium 1. Bends towards the normal. Name of this medium is medium number 1. This one medium number 2. So according to our assumption, in medium 1 velocity of light is V1 and here velocity of light is V2. It bends towards the normal means here V2 is less than V1. V2 is less than V1. Then applying Snell's law at the point of incidence, sin I divided by sin R. Change in path of light occurs in second medium with respect to first medium. 2-1. Change in path of light occurs in second medium with respect to first medium. Relative refractive index is equal to sin I divided by sin R, or this is equal to velocity of light in first medium to the velocity of light in second medium, V1 divided by V2. Equation number 3. Then equation 2/1. 2/1. N2 divided by N1 is equal to N2 C/V2 into N1 V1 divided by C. Speed of light get cancelled. Then N2 divided by N1 is equal to V1 divided by V2. Equation number 4. From equation 3 and 4, N21 is equal to V1 by V2. Here, V1 by V2 is equal to N2 divided by N1. From 3 and 4. From 3 and 4. N21 is equal to N2 divided by N1. So this is the relation between relative refractive index and absolute refractive index. relative refractive index, that is the refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium, is equal to refractive index of the second medium. It is a ratio of refractive index of the second medium to the refractive index of first medium. Or we can write one more definition for a relative refractive index. So here in this case, refractive index of the second medium is N2. Refractive index of first medium is N1. N2 is nothing but relative refractive index. Refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium, because change in path of light occurs in second medium. So relative refractive index is also defined as refractive index of the medium N2. Refractive index of the medium with refracted light ray, it is the ratio of refractive index of the medium with refracted light ray to the refractive index of the medium with incident light ray. That is also known as a relative refractive index. So in your textbook, they are going to give some values for different optical media. So let us note down the important values of certain optical media. A refractive index of vacuum is equal to 0.9997. Refractive index of air is equal to 1.0003. Here this is nearly equal to 1, this is nearly equal to 1. That means this value represents optical density of the medium. If you are going to consider the combination of vacuum and air, 1 is greater than 0.9, therefore air is denser, vacuum is rarer. Refractive index of water is equal to 1.33. A refractive index of glass is equal to 1.5. A refractive index of diamond is equal to 2.4. A refractive index of kerosene is equal to 1.7. See here, these values represents absolute refractive index of the medium, not relative refractive index. Refractive index of water is 1.33 means when we are going to consider the combination of air and water. That means this value is absolute refractive index of water, because air is easily available, and hence we can easily consider the combination of air, glass, air, water, air, diamond, air, kerosene, like this. Therefore, we are going to prefer absolute refractive index value instead of a relative refractive index. Therefore, these values represent absolute refractive index of the medium. RI of water is 1.33, absolute refractive index of water is 1.33. RI of glass is 1.5. Absolute refractive index of glass is 1.5. That means by considering the combination of air and glass,
first medium is air, normal at the point of incidence. Second medium is glass. Air, glass, sin I divided by sin R.
Here we don't know I and R. Applying Snell's law at the point of incidence,
N is equal to sin I divided by sin R.
In case of this condition, combination of air and glass. By applying value of angle of incidence and angle of refraction, here we will get 1.5. This 1.5 is nothing but absolute refractive index of glass. That means refractive index of the medium with respect to air or vacuum, with respect to air or vacuum, that is known as absolute refractive index. Absolute refractive index of glass 1.5, absolute refractive index of diamond, air diamond. Then change in path of light occurs in diamond. Here change in path of light occurs in glass. Similarly, if you are going to consider air and water, in that case change in path of light occurs in water. Therefore, this value represents refractive index of the medium at which we can observe change in path of light. In this ray diagram, we can observe change in path of light in glass. Therefore, this value is absolute refractive index of glass. Similarly, water, absolute refractive index of water. Absolute refractive index of kerosene, that is a combination of air, kerosene. Then change in path of light occurs in kerosene. Applying Snell's law at the point of incidence, that ratio gives constant value. That constant value is a refractive index, that is absolute refractive index of kerosene. Therefore, try to understand. So these value represents absolute refractive index of the medium. That means we are going to consider given medium with air or vacuum. So these values are important while solving the numericals. Try to remember these values. Okay, so this is all about refractive index and types of refractive index. It is a relative refractive index and absolute refractive index.